First Baptist Church of Dallas is joining the vaccination movement, hosting a clinic on Sunday. Good morning to Senior Pastor Dr. Robert Jeffress. First, are you vaccinated and why or why not?
Yes, I am vaccinated. I got my first vaccine in January and then followed it up with the second one. And look, Tim, we believe that all life is a gift from God that needs to be protected. And that means life not just inside the womb, as pro-life people talk about, but it's also life outside the womb. And so we think it's an important thing for us to get vaccinated so that we can get back to normal as soon as possible. And certainly with the new CDC guidelines on masks, vaccination is the quickest way back to normalcy for everyone, including churches.
Why do you think resistance is so high among, in particular, white evangelical Protestants? Does it have to do with loyalty to former President Trump and his talks at the beginning that it's a hoax?
Well, I think some people unfortunately have politicized this vaccine. And, it was interesting, Tim, on my way to my first vaccine down at Market Hall, I almost missed my exit because President Trump called me from Air Force One, but I did get there in time. And I remind people who want to politicize this, yes, Joe Biden is emphasizing the vaccines. He's done a good job in vaccine distribution, but we would have no vaccine to distribute if it weren't for President Trump and his foresight with Operation Warp Speed. So we're encouraging people not to see this as a Republican, a Democrat issue. This is an American issue. This is what we need to do to get back to normal.
Do you expect to get any blowback from your members? Because the president of the Southern Baptist Convention, Dr. J.D. Greer, got his vaccine and was accused on social media of being part of a satanic or government conspiracy.
Well, you know, when people say that and they say it's the mark of the Antichrist, I say to people, well, if President Trump was responsible for getting it developed, who does that make him? I mean, it's ridiculous. It's completely unbiblical to link this with the Antichrist. But yeah, not everybody in our congregation believes like I do. And that's a great thing about First Baptist Dallas. You don't have to agree with the pastor on everything, but the majority of our members are very excited about this.
I suspect that before you stepped out onto what could be a politically risky ledge and offered the church as a vaccine clinic, you checked with some smart people to make sure it is safe to encourage others to get the vaccine.
Absolutely. And we have some very respected doctors in our church. One was responsible for developing another vaccine that's widely used, and he's in his 80s, and he said he was going to be the first one in line to get the vaccine. And you look at great Christians like Dr. Francis Collins, who heads up the Institute of Health. He is pro-vaccine. And so I think there are plenty of good voices out there promoting the vaccine.
And you and other faith leaders have said clearly that the vaccine is one way to get back to normal. Full capacity services, events without masks, without having two seats in between the person next to you. But you can't check the vaccination cards. And you know that when you go back to normal in full capacity, there'll be a substantial number of people in the congregation at First Baptist who are not and will not get vaccinated.
There's a segment, but I think the vast majority will. And that's why we're having this vaccine clinic this Sunday. And look, we're not going to have deacons wrestling people to the ground to inject them with the vaccine. It's a personal choice. People get to decide. But I hope the majority of people will make a wise decision on this.
Dr. Robert Jeffress, thank you so much. The vaccine clinic right after Sunday service is 12:30 in the afternoon at the Fountain Plaza at First Baptist Church in downtown Dallas. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks, Tim.
Thanks.
Appreciate it.
Putting on the clinic as well.